Assalamu alaikum student. This is the exercise of the chapter The Merchant of Venice. You should write this chapter very nicely, neatly, without any spelling mistakes in your notebook. So this is a true or false over here. First one is, say whether the following statements are true or false. A. The merchant ships brought spices and other treasures from India and other countries to Italy. So the statement is true. B. Antonio had gone on a long voyage. Answer is false. C. Bassanio was very rich. False. D. Portia had many brothers and sisters. False. Portia's suitors choose the gold and silver caskets. True. F. Bassanio borrowed money from Shylock in Antonio's name. True. G. Shylock was not at all generous. True. H. Shylock demanded a pound of Antonio's flesh. True. I. Portia saved Antonio in the court of law. True. Next. Second, write a few lines about each character. So children, here each character of that lesson: Antonio, Bassanio, Shylock, Portia and Duke. So this is a few lines about their character. Antonio, he is the merchant of Venice. He was very rich and had many ships. He was a kind man. Bassanio, he was a young, handsome nobleman who didn't have any money. He wanted to marry a beautiful lady named Portia. Bassanio and Antonio were very good friends. 3. Shylock. Shylock was a miserly moneylender. He only cared for money. He hated Antonio. He lent money to Antonio on the condition that if he did not pay it back on time, he could cut off a pound of Antonio's flesh. 4. Is Portia. She was a beautiful young lady from Belmont. She was very rich and very intelligent. She saved Antonio very smartly. 5. The Duke. He had to make Antonio fulfill the condition of his bond of Shylock. Next is 3rd. Second one. Write the conditions that Portia put down to warn Shylock. Answer is, there's two conditions. First is, when cutting off Antonio's flesh, Shylock should not shed even one drop of Antonio's blood. Second one, Shylock should cut exactly 1 pound of Antonio's flesh, nothing less, nothing more. Third, write the words that are combined to make this word. So children, this is a mix up of two words. We have to separate these two words. Far away, far plus away. Nobleman, noble plus man. Whoever, who plus ever. Moneylender, money plus lender. Sometimes, some plus times. Now next, last, add proper prefixes to the following words to make new words. Children, do you prefix means that you have to add words before the given words, like kind, unkind. See, before the kind we add you and unkind. This is prefix, and the word we join after the word, that is called suffix. If there is kind, so where if they tell you to write suffix, so you have to write kindness, n-e-double-s-ness. So prefix means you have to add before the word, and suffix means you have to add after the word. So here they has given you that add proper prefix. Prefix means before word. So kind, unkind, intelligent, unintelligent, advantage, disadvantage, happy, unhappy, allow, disallow. So children, this whole lesson you have to write, write it properly and learn by heart. Thank you.